Hello! Welcome to Enoch's Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we'll be looking at the lathe tailstock. I'll be removing the tailstock from the lathe, stripping it down, checking over all the parts, seeing how it works, rebuilding it and fitting it back on the lathe. So let's go into the workshop and see how it works. This week we're looking at the tailstock. That's because I had a request from my viewer asking if I could look at the tailstock. This tailstock's off the Boxford. This end is where we have a number two Morse taper to hold the drills and chucks. Spindle lock there. This end obviously is a handle you use to wind in and out. This part here is a part I made to give me an idea how deep I'm going on a hole or anything. And this part is a part I've added. Down here we've got a grub screw on this side and the opposite side that centralizes the tailstock to the bed. And then underneath there's a clamp, and as I lift this lever at the back, that clamps the tailstock to the lathe bed. So what I intend to do in this video, we'll strip this down. I haven't taken it apart for a long time. See how it all goes together and what components are in there and what you can adjust. The first thing I'll do is wind out the quill till it comes to the end. Then you should be able to pull this through, undo the lock, pull that out. And the quill on this one has 0 to 50 millimeters on the top, 0 to 2 inches on the bottom to give you an idea of the depth. On the end it's got a bronze thread that goes on the lead screw on this. There's a slot in the bottom to stop this turning, and a grub screw there to hold the bronze thread at the end. And this particular one has got a number two Morse taper machined in this end. I'll put that on one side. What I'll do now is take the handle off. The handle's held on with a grub screw, which I've made a hole in the part I fitted so you can go straight through into the handle. Undo the grub screw. The handle will come off. So this part comes off the handle. As you see, this is just a plain diameter with a grub screw that goes through, and the grub screw locates in this dimple on the shaft. This part has this piece of spring steel that goes in there, and all that does is drags on the diameter of this so that when you set it, it moves with the handle and doesn't just rotate freely. It just makes it a stiff turn on here, so it will stay where you set the scale. To remove this, there are two cap heads on the end. All these are imperial sized bolts and screws because this lathe was made in the late 60s, early 70s when we were still using imperial. So that's the screw for the tailstock. You've just got a locating bush. There's no thread or anything in there, it just locates on the diameter, and the handle locks that in position. And then this just pushes the quill forward or backwards in the barrel. So that's the thread on there. That's not a metric thread, it's imperial. So one turn, it's nearly 2 millimeters, but it's just about 20th over 2 millimeters. So my metric scale slightly out, but when I need, or if I ever need to make a new one of these, it'll be in metric,
so that'll be correct. And they look quite easy to make. Now this is the end cap off the end. I've added this alignment part so I can see when this is on there what I'm reading. It's got an oil nipple in the top that puts oil into this part just to lubricate the shaft. There's another oil nipple on the top of this which lubricates the thread and the quill. So if I turn it round now, you'll see that's the bore. In there there's a little peg. I don't know if you can see through that. This is just the lock for the quill. Here's the zero positions for your tailstock offset. If you're turning a taper, you can pull the tailstock over. On this side, we've got the clamping lever, and that works a cam. Let's turn this over. This is normally in that position with the bed between there. And when you pull the cam lever, it pulls this in and out to lock on the bed. Now for adjustment, you've got this nut on the end. So if you find when you push your lever forwards to lock it, if you find that it's coming over that far, what you can do is tighten that nut up on the bottom. You'll have to remove the tailstock from the end of the bed so you can get up the nut. Tighten it up half a turn and it will make the lever lock in a position further back. You can just turn it to suit where you want the lever to lock. Sometimes when you're over here, it starts to interfere with other things that you're doing. You want it to lock about there, out of the way of your clamp. Just a lever and a washer. This is the clamping part made of bronze again. That radius on there clamps on the quill to lock it in the tailstock. That's just a stud with a hole around the side so the bronze can fit in. This end you have a little peg which runs in the slot on the bottom of the quill, and that just stops this turning. So when you're drilling a hole or you're machining something, to prevent this turning round in the tailstock, that little peg fits in that slot. Well, the next thing we need to take off is the cam lock. Undo the nut on the bottom. That's the clamping part that goes in your bottom of your bed and clamps up to the bed to lock the unit. And then on this part you've got a grub screw down there, which you can undo that, and that lets this lever come out. On this lever you can see the cam. As you turn this cam on the end pushes this bar in and out, and that locks up to the bed of the lathe. Goes in there, and that little grub screw goes in this groove just to stop the handle coming out when it's fitted. And there's not much more to strip down in this. So the next thing to take off is the adjustments. Slacken that screw off. One on the opposite side. Slacken that off. And that should remove this is the bottom part of the tailstock, and on this we've got machined surface. The bottom fits in the V way on your bed. This machine part here fits into the slot on each side, and on here we have two grub screws which go either side of this casting and will offset the top of the tailstock either way depending on which grub screw you have tightened up. So I'll give this a clean down and then we'll start to reassemble it. Okay, reassembly. Wiped it over to get rid of any swarf or dirt. You can see each part's numbered on this. You've got your casting number and the number of this particular base. Same on the tailstock bottom. There's a number stamped in there. And this just locates over those two. And then when this is on the tailstock, obviously your clamp lever pulls all this down and locks it up. I've set it so that the zero is in line on the back. The first thing I'll do is screw these in. So they touch the casting, and I don't want to lock this up at the moment because I don't know whether it's will be true. I'll just knit that one up because it'll hold the top on. So the next thing we can put on is the end cap and the main screw. That just pushes into there. The end cap goes on here, and then there's two cap heads that go through. Next I'll put the quill. This groove here is just to let oil from this oil nipple on the top. It goes into this groove and will move along. So on this end, first of all I want to put the ring. This ring has a piece of spring steel. The spring steel goes across the counterbore and this goes in the end. And hopefully the spring steel stays in. Just wobble it down so it clips on, and that should turn but be tight enough to move with the handle. And once that's on, all I need to do is align the grub screw with the hole on this side, put that on the shaft. In line with this dimple, tighten the grub screw up, now this collar will move whenever I need to zero it, and then when I turn the handle it will move with the handle. So you push the quill in to engage the thread and just wind it in. Now the lock, you put the bronze part on so the curve will locate on the quill. And there's a washer on the top. And then the handle. Locking handle. So when you lock that down, it pulls the bronze part into the quill and locks the spindle. The cam unit. So this goes on up that way so that this grips under the bottom of the bed, and that goes into the bottom. There are no washers on this. This nut will fit into the slot. I'll just put it about halfway and we'll see how that goes when I put it on the bed. So that will need adjusting. Next job is to put the handle in. Let me just show you, the handle goes through there. Don't push it right home because you need to get this in the middle. You see there, this bar goes in, has to go through that bar, and that locks. This just goes there. And now all this is together, I'll just nip this each side. That'll stop it falling off when I pick it up. And then also, when I put the clamp on, this gap here then, will, this will pull the top down onto the base. Let's go over to the lathe and fit this on. Make sure the cam lock is at that position. Line up this so it fits under the bed. Just want to tighten the nut a quarter of a turn. That fits in the bed. That's okay to lock in that position. If you find it's too far down or too far over, you need to slide it back off. And then what you're actually doing underneath, you take that out the slot, turn the nut round, drop it back into the slot, and then fit the tailstock back on the lathe. When you fit it on, make sure your lever is down, otherwise you're trying to fit it with the clamp on. And when you pull the clamp up, now that's locking in that position now, so what I need to do is tighten that nut up one flat. Place it back in. So you get the handle in the position you want when it locks. So now the handle locks in that position before it was down there. Or if your handle's coming all the way over, then you can just tighten the nut up a bit. And all you're doing is shortening the rod down with the nut so it locks sooner or later. So once that's on, put the clamp on. With the Allen key, slacken these two off. These are the adjustment for the taper. Put the clamp on again, and you can see the gap on each side has gone there because it's pulled this down. And slacken the clamp off, tighten this one up at the back, and it's pulling the tailstock backwards so I can get the zero mark lined up. Once the zero mark's lined up, tighten the front one up. Now that clamps the tailstock between the two grub screws on the part of the casting inside, so that's not going to move. The only thing you need to do is check if you're doing any work between centres, or when you're going to drill, check that it is in line with your tailstock, because even if it says it's on zero, it still might be out of line slightly. Because I've cleaned it all and wiped all the oil off it, all I'll do is put some oil in the top there so it lubricates the spindle. And to oil this one on the end, I've put a cutout in there, line that up with the, and then you can put the oil can into the end, pump some oil, wipe the excess oil off.
Well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.